I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. So yesterday we talked about sociopathy and mental health, and today we're talking about disability. Off to a flying start. So the question we're going to answer today is whether or not a disabled person can learn to lucid dream. And to do that, we need to break what classifies disability and how do you lucid dream, or what are the key components of lucid dreaming. So the key components of lucid dreaming involves having a good night's sleep regularly, being able to recall your dreams down regularly, being able to have prospective memory, and being able to critically analyze things. So prospective memory is something that I don't often talk about on this channel, but it is very important for lucid dreaming, and you do it all the time. Prospective memory is a plan to do something with a specific intention. So in the context of lucid dreaming, this would be a reality check. Your prospective memory has to be quite good so that you can remember to do something in the future for a planned intention. So now that we've broken lucid dreaming down into those key components, then what constitutes disability? What is disability? So there are two different types of disability in my eyes. There's the physical disability and mental disability. And each of those types of disability have different discussion points about whether or not they can lucid dream. I'll talk about physical disability first, because I think it's a bit easier to visualize physical disability. When I was younger and I was starting out this channel quite new, I had this subscriber who wanted to learn how to lucid dream because they were actually physically disabled. They couldn't walk without crutches, they couldn't do anything without the aid of external support. So they wanted to learn how to lucid dream so that they could go into the dream and be able to walk around properly or fly or be a superhero, because they couldn't do that in waking life. And I thought, well, that's a really good use for lucid dreaming. So it got me thinking recently, looking back at that, about physical disability and how tricky it would be to be able to lucid dream. Now, with physical disability rather than mental disability, you don't have to worry about prospective memory and the ability to critically analyze the situation. What you do have to worry about is whether or not you can get a good night's sleep due to your disability, and whether or not you can recall down your dreams. Let's say you haven't got any hands. How are you gonna do your dream journal? Also, if you are physically disabled and you cannot get a good night's sleep because of your disability, let's say, for example, you've got missing legs and you have phantom limb syndrome or something, where you can still feel where your leg should be and it's hurting, because that is a real thing. So as long as you can physically do the things that you want to do, then yes, you'll be able to lucid dream, just like a person who isn't physically disabled. I think a good workaround for those of you who are trying to do dream journaling when you're physically disabled is to have it like voice commanded. You don't need to write down your dreams. You can speak your dreams. And with new and improved technology now, you have speech to text everywhere. That's what I use to write stuff in Google Documents. I press Control, Shift and S, and then speak into a microphone, and it just types it out for me. It's so much quicker and it's so much easier. And you can do that on your phone. So if you have got an issue with recording down your dreams, that's probably a one way to do it. Now, the trickier thing to talk about is when we're talking about mental disability, because mental disability, depending on what type you have, can really impact your ability to critically think. And it's difficult for people like me and people like some of you who are not mentally disabled to put yourself in the shoes of someone who is mentally disabled. So for example, let's talk about, I don't know, someone who has a really low IQ because of a mental disability they have. Like they have the brain of a child, hypothetically speaking. It isn't impossible for a child to lucid dream. I've done it before. When I was 5, I lucid dream. So it is possible. But if your mental disability is impeding your ability to critically analyze things, or impeding your ability to have prospective memory, like for example, if you need a carer, then that might be a little trickier to try and lucid dream. And to my knowledge, there are no workarounds with that. You may have an alarm on your phone which will require you to do a reality check, but then your prospective memory needs to be able to think about the time where your alarm doesn't exist, and doing a reality check. But then what if you do a reality check and it comes back positive and you realize that you're in a dream, but you don't have that critical analytical ability to be able to think, oh, I am actually in a dream. It's difficult. It's really difficult. But then you have this really weird phenomenon known as spontaneous lucid dreams. It's a lucid dream in which it just happens spontaneously without your control. And that happens no matter what you do. Sometimes you can just be in a dream and you just instantly know that you're in a dream. You don't need a sign. You don't need anyone to tell you that you're in a dream. You know, because you just know that you're in a dream. So it is possible to lucid dream for someone who is mentally or physically disabled spontaneously. And that is something to think about. So last time I did a video like this, it got demonetized because the new rules are quite strict. So I did a video on sex in a lucid dream and that got demonetized. I did a video about suicide in a lucid dream and got demonetized. I'm thinking talking about disability and people trying to lucid dream may get demonetized. So I'm thinking of this as a little bit of a tester. I'm assuming yesterday's video is going to get demonetized too. Who knows? Who knows? I don't know. Giz doesn't know. So if you want to support the show financially, you can. You can be a member of this YouTube channel. If you click the join button, or you can join the Patreon page. Either way, happy as Larry. And Larry is happy. Thank you very much for subscribing. Join me tomorrow. Tomorrow's video. What's that going to be? So tomorrow's video is going to be about what I have been up to since I've been away from YouTube. It'll be quite an interesting story. So stick around for that. And until tomorrow.